Good morning students, we were discussing about center of mass and we have calculated center of mass of two particles lying on x axis and then we calculated center of mass of three particles of different masses m1, m2, m3 lying on a xy plane and then we calculated the position of center of mass, position of center of mass by x coordinate and y coordinate of center of mass. X coordinate of center of mass, capital X becomes equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Similarly, y coordinate of center of mass, capital Y equal to m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 whole divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. So that's how we calculated mass weighted average of the particles. So that gives us position of center of mass. Then while concluding, I told one point: if all the masses of the particles are same, if m1 equal to m2 equal to m3 equal to m, let us say m, all the masses are of same values m, then if there are three particles, then the center of mass will be exactly at its centroid. Center of mass will be exactly at the centroid formed by the triangle. Triangle formed by these particles. But if the masses are different, if m1 is different, m2 is different and m3 is different, then remember the center of mass will not be at centroid. Please correct it. Center of mass will not be at centroid. It will be at some other point. Okay. That will come to know once we solve one problem. Before that, what is the significance of center of mass? Let us look at this example. Suppose I have taken a duster. If I take this duster and throw it, you know that it undergoes the projectile motion. It undergoes a projectile motion. This is what we have studied previously in the previous topic. But one particle of this duster perfectly undergoes a projectile motion. But what about other parts of the body? If you just observe this, if you just observe this, I will throw it once again. When I throw it, the duster is undergoing a rotational motion. It not only undergoes translation motion, it also undergoes rotational motion during its travel. So we have to account for that because we are studying the motion of a rigid body. So I have drawn a rough diagram. If you throw a duster or for that matter any object, one particle does not change its path at all. That particle perfectly undergoes the required path, that is trajectory of a projectile. Whereas other particles, if you concentrate, other particles, they undergo the rotational motion. They are undergoing rotational motion. So in this way, a body rotates along with its usual path. The body rotates and falls on the other side. So what is that point which does not undergo any rotational motion? That point is called the center of mass. To give one example, you must have seen a girl or a boy walking on a tight rope, balancing his body with the help of a long rod. So he or she requires a long rod. So he or she balances while walking on the rope carefully with the help of that rod. So that rod helps to keep the center of mass of that person to be exactly on the rope. If the center of mass shifts towards the right side, then using the rod will be heavy. Actually it is a heavy rod. Using the rod, he or she balances by taking the rod towards left side. If she is unbalanced and going to fall towards left side, then with the help of that rod she brings the rod towards right side and changes the position of center of mass, so that center of mass exactly should be lying on the line joining the rope, so that she can walk without any fear. She can complete that task. So that is the significance of center of mass. So when a rigid body is in motion, we are studying what happens to all the particles. So we have considered a rigid body as a system of particles and how to find out the center of mass. So if it is a system of n number of particles, then center of mass is given by the position of center of mass of a body, rigid body, of a rigid body having n particles is given by x is equal to summation of mi xi I equal to 1 up to n divided by sum of all the masses. That gives us capital M, that is mass of the body. Similarly, we got the y coordinate. The y coordinate is given by summation of mi yi I equal to 1 up to n divided by capital M. Capital M we got by summation of all the masses. And if it is in space, if the rigid body is in space, then the z coordinate should also be considered. Z coordinate of that rigid body, center of mass of that rigid body, z coordinate is given by summation of mi zi I equal to 1 up to n divided by m. Thus we get three coordinates x, y, z. So we can write the position of center of mass as position vector of center of mass. Position vector of center of mass. Position vector of center of mass. Now we can write using these coordinates x, y, z. X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Right? Out of this, if you are considering only one particle, let us say ith particle, then position vector of that ith particle is given by xi I cap plus yi j cap plus zi k cap. Where this gives us position vector of I particle. So this is for a rigid body. Now rigid body may not be having the mass uniformly distributed. If a rigid body is having mass distributed continuously, consider a rigid body like a scale. Scale is having the mass being distributed uniformly throughout. It has a fixed length, fixed breadth and thickness. It has got thickness, breadth as well as length. So mass is uniformly distributed. Here we will not be able to identify the particles. You cannot say, okay, even if you say it is n number of particles, the number n will be very huge. Then it becomes very difficult for us to find the center of mass, I mean to calculate the center of mass using this equation. In such case, what to do, how to do? Then in such case, we divide this entire rigid body. I am giving you example of this scale. It may be a thin rod having certain radius and having certain length L, such that the radius is very small compared to the length of the rod. So if you take such rod, how to find out the position of center of mass wherein the mass is uniformly distributed? There we need to consider another method, that we first apply summation method, then we apply integration method. summation method by dividing the entire rod or entire scale into different masses, say delta m 1, delta m 2, delta m 3, delta m 4, delta m 5, delta m 6, delta m 7 up to delta m n. So we can consider this entire rod consisting of different masses, delta m 1, delta m 2, delta m 3, say n number of masses like delta m n. Then we will find out the by usual method, and then we will apply summation. Let us see. For a body like meter stick or a thin rod, or even you can consider a meter ruler, wherein the radius is smaller compared to the length, the atoms and molecules are so closely packed, so it becomes difficult to find the position of center of mass using these equations. We consider these as rigid bodies, with continuous distribution of mass. So I have considered an example wherein a meter stick or such as a thin rod, or even you can consider a wheel or a sphere wherein the mass is continuously distributed. So in such case, how to find the center of mass? So we consider the entire stick, as I told you, consisting of n number of masses, and we consider the entire stick be divided into equal number of, say n number of equal portions, n number of equal regions, equal volumes you can say. Each one will be having certain mass, delta m1, delta m2, delta m3, delta m4, delta m5, like that up to delta mn. So we find out the position of, in such case, the position of center of mass now becomes x equal to delta m1 x1 plus delta m2 x2, delta m2 x2. As instead of considering individual masses, because if you consider individual masses, there are infinity number of molecules, it becomes very difficult. So we change that concept as consisting of certain regions having certain, so think that it is equally divided of certain regions having a fixed number of mass, like a fixed amount of mass, like delta m1, delta m2 and so on. Then so on, let us say delta mi, xi, so on up to delta mn, delta mn, xi, whole divided by delta m1 plus delta m2 plus and so on plus delta mi, where I particle is any general particle, it may be 100th or it may be 1000th or it may be 50th or it may be 10th, so I in general particle plus up to delta mn. So the denominator definitely gives you total mass of the body. So I can write this in short as summation delta mi xi, I equal to 1 up to n, if it is divided into n parts, whole divided by total mass. So this becomes x coordinate. Similarly, y coordinate I can write directly, I can write y coordinate in the same manner. I equal to 1 up to n delta mi yi divided by m. And thus, similarly, z coordinate can be written as summation of I equal to 1 up to n delta mi zi divided by m.
So these are the x, y, z coordinates of the center of mass of such rigid bodies.
Now again, this will be an approximate method wherein we have considered the entire scale or rod to be consisting of n number of particles, n number of masses, right? If suppose this n is very huge, then what we will do? We will reduce this delta m to infinitesimally small value dm. If n is very high, like in general in cases of rigid bodies, any rigid body you take, whether it is a rod or a sphere or a cylinder or a wheel or a disc, whether it is any rigid body, then number of particles will be very high. If n of such masses is very high, then we consider delta mi to be reduced to dm, where dm is infinitesimally small mass, and we replace this summation. Summation is replaced by integration. Summation sigma I equal to 1 up to n is replaced by integration method. This is integration I equal to 1 up to n. Then what happens to this equation? Then this becomes almost exact method to find the center of mass. In that case, we get same thing I will write. We get x as equal to integral of x dm divided by summation of all masses, integration of dm. Of course, integration of dm definitely gives you same total mass of the body. So this I can write as integration of x dm by total mass m. Similarly, I can write what is y axis, y coordinate. Y coordinate becomes integration of y dm divided by capital M. And z coordinate, I will write z coordinate here, integration of z dm divided by M. So this gives us better solution to find the x, y and z coordinates of center of mass using integration method. So using such a method, we will be able to find out the center of mass, right? Now suppose if we choose the position of center of mass as the origin of the frame of reference. If origin of the frame of reference is situated exactly at the center of mass, then what happens to the equation of center of mass? It's interesting. If the center of mass of such a rigid body lies on the origin of frame of reference, means if I take origin as the position of center of mass, then you know the position vector of center of mass becomes zero. It implies the x, y, z coordinates of the center of mass become 0, 0, 0. Become 0, 0, 0. In that case, what happens? Then the equation for center of mass. What is that equation for center of mass? X I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. This becomes equal to 0. This implies, what is the value of x? Just now we have written, value of x becomes x dm by m equal to 0, because x equal to 0. Then similarly, y value, y is also 0. So y dm by capital M is equal to 0. And similarly, z is equal to that is also 0, so it becomes
So integral of z dm by m also become equal to 0. So this implies if you take m to the right hand side, m multiplied by 0 becomes 0. So this implies integral of x dm equal to integral of y dm equal to integral of z dm equal to 0. This is the situation when the position of center of mass is chosen as origin. So equation becomes simple. So while solving the numerical problems, we use this concept to find the center of mass of any given rigid body, whether it is a meter stick or a thin rod, or if it is a wheel. Wheel means it's a ring, heavy ring with certain radius is called as wheel. Then if it is a disc, then we can take, for example, cylinder, a solid cylinder, and then hollow cylinder, sphere. For all these we can apply this simple concept to find the center of mass. So in the numerical problems, if we choose one particular point as a origin, then it becomes easy to find out the center of mass. So finally, in terms of position vector of center of mass, I can write position vector of center of mass, I can write as vector r is equal to summation of mi ri vector divided by m, mi ri vector, where you see I wrote earlier ri is the position vector of ith particle, is given by xi I cap plus yi j cap plus zi k cap. And what is capital R? Capital R is the position vector of center of mass, which is r equal to x I cap plus capital y j cap plus capital z k cap. So the above one is ith particle. So ith particle can be any reference particle. So this is the case when we apply summation method. For the particles of the rigid body to be very high, if n is very high as we have just now considered, for uniform distribution of mass, for continuous distribution of mass, for any rigid body having continuous distribution of mass, we get for rigid body, considered as continuous distribution of mass, we replace this summation by integral. So same r now becomes integral of r dm ri dm divided by m. Same thing, summation is replaced by r. Now if the center of mass lies on origin, just now we have noted, if the center of mass lies on origin, what happens to this above equation? The left hand side becomes 0. Then summation mi ri cap becomes equal to 0 divided by m. Okay, next step, if you take this m to the right hand side, it becomes 0. So this implies summation mi ri cap ri vector is equal to 0. So this is the vector notation to find the position of the particles with respect to center of mass. Then if it is continuous distribution of mass, for the second equation, for this equation, it becomes same thing, replaced by integral. Integral r dm becomes r dm divided by m equal to 0. This implies integral of r dm equal to 0. R dm equal to 0. This is the case when the center of mass lies on the origin, where capital X, capital Y, capital Z are corresponding to 0, 0, 0.
So now with this thing in our mind, let us solve one simple problem. Let us solve one simple problem. It's a very simple problem consisting of only three particles on the xy plane. Find the center of mass of three particles at the vertices of an equilateral triangle. Three particles are there, m1, m2, m3, which are at the vertices of an equilateral triangle. The masses of the particles are 100 gram, 150 gram and 200 gram respectively. M1 is 100, m2 is 150, m3 is 200 gram, let us say. Each side of the equilateral triangle is 0.5 meter long. Each side is half meter long. So it is exactly half meter long. So it is an equilateral triangle. You are asked to find out the center of mass of these three particles. One thing you remember, if the masses are equal, then there is no difficulty in finding out the center of mass, which is the geometrical center that becomes the centroid of the triangle. But centroid of the triangle. But here the masses are different. M1 is 100, M2 is 150 and M3 is 200 gram. Therefore, definitely center of mass will not be lying at the centroid. Let us find out the position. So, here the coordinates are given. The mass M1 is chosen at origin. The mass M1 is chosen at origin. So, the coordinates of that mass M1 become 0, 0. The problem becomes simple. Mass M1 is at origin, so that its coordinates become 0, 0. Mass M2 definitely will be at 0.50. Next coordinate becomes 0.5 meter. Y coordinate becomes 0. Then B will be exactly at 0.25. Since it is an equilateral triangle, so B will be at X coordinate exactly 0.25 meter. And if you apply the Pythagoras theorem, you can find out the y coordinate becomes 0.25 root 3. 0.25 root 3. Right? So, this side, each side is 0.5 meter. So, this is also 0.5 meter, this is 0.25. So, you can find out what is this y coordinate, that is height. Using Pythagoras theorem, it becomes 0.25 root 3. So, if these are the coordinates and the masses, you are asked to find out the center of mass. Equation for center of mass. Position of center of mass for a system of three particles on xy plane. So first I will write x coordinate. So the center of mass has xy as the coordinates. So let me write x coordinate. So by the knowledge of equation, m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 whole divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. This becomes x coordinate. Similarly, I can find out what is the y coordinate. Y coordinate will be m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. Mass weighted average, mass weighted mean, right? Now, what is m1? m1 is 100 gram. Just substitute 100 gram into what is x1? x1 is 0. 100 gram into 0, so that becomes m1 h1 plus m2. m2 is chosen as 150 into x2. x2 value is 0.5 plus m3. m3 is 200 gram into x3. x3 we got it as exactly half, that is 0.25 meter. 0.25 whole divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3. M1 plus m2 plus m3 100 plus 150 plus 200. So if you work it out, this becomes zero, and following the multiples we get. So look here, although I have expressed this in the gram meters, in the denominator also it is gram, so this becomes gram meter, and in the denominator it is gram, so gram gram cancels, so you will be getting in terms of position in meter. So first one is 0 plus point, so it becomes 75, right? 75 plus 1/4 of 200 becomes 50. 1/4 of 200 becomes 50. Whole divided by 100 plus 200 becomes 300. 300 plus 150, 450. So thus it becomes 125. Right? 75 plus 50, 125 divided by 450. So if you cancel this, we get the exact value of x. 25 flies up, 125. 25 flies up, 125. 25 ones up, 25. You are left with 150. You are left with 15. 25, 45 minus 25 becomes 20. Okay, 20. 20 and this 0 becomes 200. So 25 takes up. So it becomes 5 by 18. So x coordinate becomes 5 by 18 meter. So decimal point you can find out. Similarly, let us find out y coordinate. Y coordinates, if you calculate this, here m1 y1. M1 is again 100 into 0, calculate directly 0. 100 into 0 becomes 0 because y coordinate is 0. Then second one, m2 is 0.5, m2 is 150. And y coordinate is again 0. M2 is 150 and y coordinate is again 0. Both are lying on the x axis, therefore y coordinate is 0. So 0 plus 0 plus m3 y3. M3 is 200 into 0.2523. 200 into 0.2523 whole divided by total mass as well as 450. So if you calculate this, 1/4 of 200, you know, 50. So it becomes 50√3 divided by 450. So 0 if you cancel, 5 ones are 5, 9 are. So √3 divided by 9. So this becomes y coordinate.
√3 divided by 9 comes out to be
1/3√3. If you rationalize this. So if you just rationalize this, √3 into √3, if you rationalize this, then you will get y coordinate becomes 3/9, that is 1/3, 1/3.